Similarly, the vaginal examination is also recommended for the same way, just to see the presence or absence of any sort of discharge, their color, and the enlargement of the vagina. But you know that during the estrus period, or estrus or pro-estrus period, the vulva, usually it is normally swollen 2 to 3 times from its normal size, and it appears more turgid, and you can also see the hemorrhagic or straw colored discharge that is coming out. And this is the normal phenomenon in bitches when they are having the pro-estrus period. So this vaginal examination that is also carried out just to see whether the vagina that is having some certain abnormal growth or tumor which are lying within it, and the size of the vagina that is also examined, and similarly the any sort of abnormal discharge if it is lying within the vagina, that is also noted. So clinical pathology. This is another very effective tool that most of the time gives you the gives you or enables you to diagnose the different reproductive issues, the different reproductive problems, like the cytological examinations, the examination of the discharge, and similarly. Examination. This sort of examination will helps you to make a difference between the inflammation and the neoplasia. Similarly, culturing techniques that can be used just to rule out the presence of certain pathological bacteria, whether these bacteria may be the anaerobic bacteria or aerobic bacteria. And similarly, this culturing technique can also help you whether the animal that is having certain infectious problems like brucellosis testing. So hormonal concentration that are also occasionally helpful for diagnosing the female reproductive problems, like in females, the level of the estradiol that is usually less than 10 picogram per ml in the late anestrus, but this level increased more than 10 picogram on the onset of the proestrus, and it takes its peak of 50 to 100 picogram per ml at late proestrus. Similarly, the level of the progesterone, it is 0.5 to 1 nanogram per ml during the anestrus and proestrus, and it get elevated to 2 to 5 nanogram per ml at luteinizing hormone surge level, and it get its peak of 15 to 19 nanogram per ml around about 15 to 30 days later, and slowly it get decreased and become less than 2 nanogram per ml before the onset of the, and so far maintenance before the onset of the parturition. So maintenance of the pregnancy, it always require more than 2 nanogram per ml of progesterone. So whenever its level decreases less than 2 nanogram, so it shows the onset of the parturition, and parturition always that is carried out when the level of the progesterone that is less than 2 nanogram per ml. Similarly, another important hormonal profile that is of LH, that also gives you certain distinguishing or distinctions between the neutered and the intact bitches or queens. And similarly, if it is more than 1 nanogram per ml of LH, it will show you that the LH surge that is being approaching, and it will gives you a very good time to predict the ideal breeding time and predict the parturition. Similarly, diagnostic imaging is very important tool when you are performing the reproductive surgery, and particularly the radiography, that can be proved as an effective tool to gives you the detail of the gravid uterus, and this gravid uterus can be detected by using the radiography at the day 31 to 38 days, and the fetal skeletal mineralization that can be identified by 40